I do not do cardio to lose weight. I do cardio so that one day I can wear a corset and a 500-pound Rococo-style ball gown and run through the gardens of Versailles without having to stop and catch my breath.
This is me and my friend Monica. When we were little, we didn't really feel like we belong in society. I guess you can say not feeling pretty or handsome too. It's 'cause we are Asian, specifically Southeast Asian. I can never be someone's handsome Prince Charming. And Monica, well, she was made fun of for dressing up like Cinderella. 'Cause Cinderella can never be Asian. Well, look at us hoes now.
In a world of locked rooms, the man with the key is king. And honey, you should see me in a crown.
Jim Moriarty.
And they called her Aurora.
Sweet Aurora.
Are your preferences for romance tropes at odds with your feminism? Me too, let's discuss it. Mine's mostly from fantasy books, but it's when the main character's love interest keeps calling her princess, even though she's not a princess. Don't come for me yet, just listen. If I walked into a bar and a strange guy approached me and called me princess, well then he'd have to die. And if my husband called me princess, I would assume he's making some kind of insult and be forced to take his phone and change all the contact names to Dennis Quaid or Jaden Smith. But if a tall, muscled, sword-wielding, morally grey ruffian in the woods wanted to smirk at me and call me princess, that would be fine.
Find your dreams come true, and I wonder if you know what it means.
My childhood trauma is like the ocean. 95% of it is unexplored.
And I'm your future queen.
Then you'll learn to respect my decision.
Respect goes both ways.
I will not have a relationship like your mother and father.
I am nothing like my father, and for you to suggest otherwise...
Then why are you acting like him?
I'm not.
Got a secret, can you keep it? Swear this one you'll save. Better lock it in your pocket, taking this one to the grave. If I show you, then I know you won't tell what I said. 'Cause two can keep a secret if one of them is dead.
Everyone else in the room can see it. Everyone else but you.
Family have had their fair share of royal rebels, but none of them have done it quite as well as Princess Louise. You may recognise this statue. It sits outside Kensington Palace and shows one of the palace's most famous former residents, Queen Victoria. But it was created by her daughter, Princess Louise, who's honestly a bit of an underrated 19th century icon. And Louise was a royal rebel. She spent her time creating sculptures with the Pre-Raphaelites, promoting other women artists, encouraging women in medicine, and the suffragist movement. She wore radical artsy clothes, abandoned the family jewels to create her own jewellery, and scandalously wore her hair partially down. But the scandals didn't stop there. She had a litany of rumoured affairs, including one with her art tutor. One rumour from the time tells us that he died whilst doing the deed with the princess in her studio. In order to avoid scandal, the princess and her ladies-in-waiting rolled him up in a carpet and had him delivered to his studio so that he could be discovered there instead.
Hello again, we are back with another aesthetics-inspired look. This time we are visiting the realm of royalty-core, knight-core, basically anything that you can fit inside the fantasy world. We are also using the most beautiful fabric I have ever seen in my life, and also the hardest fabric I've ever worked with. But don't worry, the corgi rigs really helped. Now this look had the coolest sleeve style I have ever done, and then I went ahead and cut 6 layers of tulle for the circle skirt, and this is what she ended up looking like. I love her, and I hope you guys do.
She's a woman. There's no way she could stab 3 grown men.
That's a bit sexist. A woman could easily kill a man. With the right motivation.
The killers come down to get a ball through. You scaring them, sit up.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I can teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard and they're like, it's better than yours. Damn right, it's better than yours. I can teach you.
You've heard of hot girl summer. Now get ready for hot wench summer.
Give me some carrot magic in the air.
In response to not getting the attention I deserve, I've decided I will cause problems on purpose.